Hello students, today we will start with chapter number 4, that is reproductive health. Now earlier we have discussed about different types of reproduction, asexual, sexual implants, human being, etc. Now in this chapter we will deal with the reproductive health, which is concerned with the normal reproductive system, normal reproductive organs with normal functioning, etc. In this chapter, we'll also study about different types of STDs, ART, then different types of the objectives of reproductive health, what are the plannings or programs run by government or non-governmental organizations, all these we'll study one by one. Actually, according to WHO, World Health Organization, reproductive health can be defined as the total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social point of view. That means all the people should have normal reproductive organ, their functioning, as well as they should be from the emotional and behavioral point of view, they should be healthy. So all these points should be, all these terms should be there for reproductive health. In 1951, Indian government has launched the family planning program, and according to that program, it was mainly based upon the birth control, population control, as well as the well-being of care of the mother, child, etc. So many things were there, and later on that was also evaluated time to time, and later on nowadays this program is now known as RCH, that is Reproductive and Child Health Program. Objectives of this program is to create awareness among the people related sex related aspects. That means all the awareness should be given to the people of that age group regarding the things, that is myth, to avoid the myth, misconception, etc. Then introduction of sex education in school, because the student who are moving towards the adolescence are in that case in the school only. So that's why there should be introduction of sex education to know the right thing, that they should be given the right information and to avoid myth and misconception. Then different types of STDs, that is sexually transmitted disease, what are the cause of the disease, how can we get prevented from that. So all these things that should be given. Now regarding adolescence, what are the problems regarding adolescence, what are the changes occurring during this adolescence, and what are do's and don'ts, all these things should be given to by this program. Now female feticide, that means due to this is our program, or you can see this is the phenomena that is known as amniocentesis, which give us facility to test the fetus during the early stage of fetus, and that time the sex of the child can also be known. So nowadays that amniocentesis is misused as a female feticide, so that should be stopped. Then population control, because our population growth is at an alarming rate, that's why that should be controlled by different methods. So all these things, all these awareness should be given to the people by different media, like audio visual media, print media, that by government organizations as well as different types of NGOs, they are working in this field. Now we'll study about the population explosion. Now MMR, that is maternal mortality rate, and IMR, that is infant mortality rate. Due to different types of facilities in nowadays, the rate of MMR and IFR declines, and that leads to the increase of the population, and all of these leads to the population explosion. For that, time to time we are doing so many methods, government and non-governmental organizations are also doing a lot in this area. 11th of July, we are celebrating as the World Population Day to create awareness among the people regarding the population explosion. One of the methods, that is birth control method, is utilized, or it is given awareness among the people to use this method, because the birth control is necessary to stop the population explosion. Now there are different methods of birth control, and that is, first one is the natural method by the nature only, and that is lactational amenorrhea, etc. Now barrier method, like use of condoms, diaphragms, etc. Then IUD, that is intrauterine device, use of this, that is copper T, loop, etc., which are able to prevent the fusion of the sperm as well as ovum. Now oral contraceptives, that is in the form of pills, etc. Some of the examples are Sahili, etc. Now having the two combinations, either it is progesterone, doses of progesterone, or progesterone and estrogen combination, that can be given through the pills or by injections also, they are nowadays available. And the duration is different, like 5 days hour or 21 days, like that. That is, and that should be taken under the professional guidance. Now, this surgical method, this is one of the sure shot as well as the very important method, that is surgical method, vasectomy and tubectomy. For birth control, there are surgical methods, which is the most effective one, and which is of two types, that is vasectomy and tubectomy. Vasectomy for sterilization of male, it is used in this, in which the vasa deferens of the male is cut down, removed or tied, so that it will prevent the fusion of the sperm with the ovum. And in this case, in this way, the male is become sterile, and this is sterilization process, and that is done inside the scrotum part. Now in case of female, it is known as tubectomy, because here the fallopian tube, the small part of fallopian tube, is removed, incision is there, and it is tied, so that it will prevent the fusion of the ovum with the male's sperm, and that is done in the abdominal region through vagina. So these are known as the surgical methods, which are most effective method for the birth control, population birth control. Now the one more topic is there, that is MTP, that is medical termination of pregnancy. In 1971, Indian government had made this MTP legalized, but under some circumstances, special circumstances, conditions, in which the artificial abortion can be made, in which when the mother having some problem, or that is dangerous for the mother or the fetus, in that case it has been legalized. But nowadays, with the help of this amniocentesis, it is now misused and it results in female feticide.
For population control, there are two methods, vasectomy and tubectomy, which is surgical method and permanent method in human being. Vasectomy is the method which is done in males, in which vas deferens is cut down and tied, so that it will prevent the path of the sperm, and in this way the population control can be done. This figure is showing tubectomy, which is done in females for the population control, in which you can see here the fallopian tube is cut down and tied, so that it will not give the pathway for the ovum, so that it will be prevented from implantation and fertilization, and in this way the population control can be done. Here you can see different types of STDs, that is sexually transmitted diseases, along with their pathogens as well as their symptoms. See the list of these STDs with their pathogens.